Mammoths, undeniably the most iconic animals of the Cenozoic era, first appeared in the early Pliocene and roamed the Earth for roughly 5 million years until their extinction some 4,000 years ago. But what factors led to their demise, and where did the last mammoths seek refuge? Before answering these questions, let's briefly explore the evolutionary journey of these ancient giants. The remarkable success of mammoths is reflected not just by their long existence, but also by their widespread distribution, as they managed to colonize nearly every part of the world except for South America, Australia, and Antarctica, which had been geographically isolated well before the emergence of the Mammuthus genus. The earliest known representative, Mammuthus subplaniferans, which is also believed to be the ancestor of all later forms, emerged in present-day southern and eastern Africa. Then, 3 million years ago, another species, Mammuthus rumanus, spread into Europe and China. Later, this species evolved into Mammuthus meridionalis, which in turn gave rise to Mammuthus trogontherii, better known as the steppe mammoth, the largest mammoth species ever discovered. Eventually, mammoths covered most of Eurasia, and between 1.5 and 1.3 million years ago, steppe mammoths journeyed to North America. This migration occurred via Beringia, a land bridge once connecting what is now northwestern Canada and western Alaska with northeastern Siberia. In North America, the expansion of this species led to the emergence of Mammuthus columbi, commonly known as the Columbian mammoth. Meanwhile, in Siberia, it led to the rise of Mammuthus primigenius, widely recognized as the woolly mammoth. Subsequently, woolly mammoths replaced the earlier steppe mammoths in Europe during the late Middle Pleistocene around 200,000 years ago, becoming one of the last in the line of mammoth species to exist. Mammoths once dominated across the entire northern hemisphere. However, around 11,700 years ago, as the last glacial period concluded, all Columbian mammoths and the majority of woolly mammoths died out as part of the mass extinction of megafauna in northern Eurasia and the Americas. The reasons for their demise have been the subject of various theories, ranging from climatic events and diseases to human activity. The woolly mammoth, well adapted to the harsh conditions of the Ice Age, possessed a specialized coat for warmth, featuring a two-layered fur system with a dense undercoat for insulation and an outer layer of long, coarse guard hairs, some up to 90 centimeters, or about 3 feet long. In addition, they had smaller ears and shorter tails compared to today's elephants, minimizing heat loss. In their habitat, known as the mammoth steppe, mammoths flourished and fed primarily on grasses and sedges. Once stretching across northern Eurasia and North America, these areas were, contrary to popular belief, not covered in ice and snow. Instead, they supported a rapidly growing and diverse array of plant life. However, the end of the Pleistocene epoch brought significant environmental changes. The progressive warming, coupled with glacial retreat and rising sea levels, led to the transformation of these habitats, with trees and wetland plants replacing the mammoth steppe. As a result, these animals were driven to isolated areas in Eurasia. Although mammoths were incredibly resilient animals, having survived numerous previous warming episodes, therefore it is unlikely that global warming alone could have caused their disappearance. Another critical factor likely contributing to the woolly mammoth extinction was the rapid expansion and development of the human species, with which they coexisted for at least 2,000 years. Archaeological evidence indicates that humans, initially living south of the mammoth habitats, adapted to the north's harsh climates and utilized mammoth bones and tusks for weapons, tools, and dwellings. This strongly suggests that humans hunted these prehistoric behemoths. In the end, it appears to have been a combination of both rapid climate change and intense human hunting that sealed the fate of the mainland mammoth populations. Yet on isolated islands, small populations managed to survive for a few thousand more years. While recent studies indicate that mainland populations may have persisted for longer than previously believed, the last mammoths found refuge on two islands, facing a fate vastly different from their continental counterparts. The first of these refugees was St. Paul Island, located 280 miles from Alaska in the Bering Sea. Mammoths here managed to evade extinction until about 5,600 years ago. The exact cause of their extinction on this island has long been a matter of speculation. The most credible theory points to a lack of fresh water. Post-ice age warming led to the rise of sea levels, resulting in some lakes being lost to ocean or mixing with salt water. Given that modern elephants require up to 200 liters of water daily, it's reasonable to assume mammoths had comparable needs. On the island, the limited water resources would have been crucial for their survival. This theory is further supported by the fact that during periods of drought, only one lake was available. If this only water source dried up, it could have been fatal. Yet the last stand of this once thriving species took place on the considerably larger Wrangel Island, situated north of the eastern tip of Siberia. Much like the population on St. Paul, mammoths on this island became trapped as sea levels rose. This isolation led to a dramatic reduction of genetic diversity, resulting in a small inbred population of around 300 individuals. This hypothesis is supported by a study from 2020, in which scientists analyzed the genes of the Wrangel Island mammoth and compared them with those from mainland populations and modern-day Asian elephants. The research highlighted distinct genetic abnormalities in the Wrangel population caused by generations of inbreeding. These mutations included diabetes, low sperm count, and defects in olfactory receptors, potentially affecting their foraging skills and the ability to detect food. In fact, the genetic makeup of the Wrangel mammoth population had accumulated such a significant number of mutations that it could be described as experiencing a genomic meltdown, ultimately leading to the definitive extinction of this species about 4,000 years ago. Despite their once unmatched supremacy, the last populations of the Ice Age giants faced a rather bitter end, and the echoes of their extinction still resonate in our world today. Although these majestic animals may seem long gone, the pyramids in Giza had already stood for around 500 years before the last mammoths of Wrangel Island finally disappeared, highlighting the relatively recent nature of their extinction. However, it might be too soon to mourn this loss. Advances in DNA extraction and sequencing has opened the door to reconstructing entire genome sequences of extinct species. So, there is a possibility that we may witness the return of this species to the steppes of Siberia one day. But more about that in this video.